Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His
bless the Lord, oh. If you have any more prayer requests, let them be known now. Sister Moden. Amen. Sister Blanett. Amen. Amen. Sister Ashley.
Pray for me and my family. And also, Sister Harris is asking that the church prays for healing of her body.
Amen. 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 Brother
Holloway.
Amen. Amen. You got your prayer. Continue to pray for me and my family. Souls on the altar in the service, you can also today.
Yes.
Amen, Sister Hope.
Remember the extended family of
Sister
Harris that is here.
Amen. Amen. Bringing them
back again.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
It would be no other request. Reach out and touch the Lord. Your blood, Lord Jesus. We're freed by your name, Lord. We thank Jesus. Hallelujah for the liberty that you've given your people. My God, we thank you, Lord, for your mercy and your grace that has kept us, oh Lord Jesus. We thank and we praise you today, Lord Jesus, for bringing us into a place to hear word from you on today. My God, have a heart to be ready, Lord Jesus. Move every way, Lord Jesus, that's easily besetting us, Lord Jesus. From here, you can walk it in the authority of your word. My God, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to strengthen the people's needs today. My God, help us to stay focused on what's true and what is right. My God, help us, oh Lord Jesus, to lay down every weight. My God, today we ask you to come into the sanctuary, Lord Jesus, to be in the midst of your people, Lord Jesus, to help us to lift up holy hands, Lord Jesus, to praise and magnify your name. My God, we ask you to remember our pastor on this morning. Strengthen our mind, body, and soul, Lord Jesus. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to bless his family, Lord Jesus. Remember the speaker of the hour, Lord Jesus, as she delivers the word, my God. We ask you to be in the midst of the word. Help our hearts to receive the word. Help us not to come in the same way we, hallelujah, help us not to go out the same way we came in. But my God, let your word do what it's sent out to do. To break yokes, my God. To strengthen us. And give us life more abundantly, my God. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to walk up and down in this place. That sick is in the room on today. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to touch, heal, and deliver, my God. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to help us to roam freely in the spirit of your name, my God. Hallelujah. We thank you today. For you're worthy of all praise, all glory, and all honor, my God. We ask you, Lord Jesus, hallelujah, to be our strength. Lord Jesus, to be our help in a time of trouble, my God. Help us to know that you are our strength. And you, everything that we need, Lord Jesus, is in thy name, my God. We ask you, Lord Jesus, today to be our help right now, Lord Jesus. To be our help right now, Lord Jesus. My God, the devil's trying to distract us and pull us down. And we ask you, Lord Jesus, to help us to go forth in thy name, my God. Help us, oh Lord Jesus, hallelujah, to see you in everything we do, my God. My God, we ask you to remember the sick and bereaved, my God. We ask you, Lord Jesus, remember those who spoke, hallelujah, and those unspoken requests. Hallelujah, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to bless this morning. Lord Jesus, we thank and we praise you for all you've done, my God. We ask you to remember each and every prayer request. Lord Jesus, in your name we pray. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come on, put your hands together like you know God is listening to your prayer. My God, we ask you to remain standing and get your Bibles out for our scripture reading and say amen for Evangelist where she leads us.
Psalms 118 in responsive reading. Psalms 118. Well, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, because his mercy endureth forever.
Let Israel now say that his mercy endures forever.
Let the house of Aaron now say that his mercy endureth forever.
Let them now that fear the Lord say that his mercy endureth forever.
I called upon the Lord in distress. The Lord answered me and set me in a large place.
The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do unto me?
The Lord taketh my part with them that help me. Therefore shall I see my desire upon them that hate me.
It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man.
It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes.
All nations compass me about, but in the name of the Lord will I destroy them.
They compass me about, yea, they compass me about, but in the name of the Lord I will destroy them.
They compass me about like bees. They are quenched as the fire of thorns. In the name of the Lord, I will destroy them.
Thou hast thrust sore at me that I might fall, but the Lord helped me.
The Lord is my strength and stronghold, and has become my salvation.
The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tabernacle of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly.
The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly.
I shall not die, but live. And declare the works of the Lord.
The Lord hath taken me sore, but he hath not given me over unto death.
Open to me the gates of righteousness, I will go into them and I will praise the Lord.
The day of the Lord into which the righteous shall enter.
I will praise thee, for thou hast heard me, and I become my salvation.
The stones and builders refused, and become a hailstone of the corner.
This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes.
This is the day which the Lord hath made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it.
Say now, I beseech thee, O Lord. O Lord, I beseech thee, send now prosperity.
Blessed be ye that come from in the name of the Lord. We have blessed you on our house of the Lord.
God is the Lord, which hath shown us light. Bind the sacrifice with cords, even unto the horns of the altar.
Thou art my God, and I will praise thee. Thou art my God, and I will exalt thee.
29 altogether. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. For his mercy endureth forever. And may the Lord bless you to the reading of his word. Coming down, down, down. Coming down, down, down. The glory of the Lord is coming down. When the saints begin to pray, thinking, Lord, just pass away. Then the glory of the Lord is coming down.
Thank you. Thank you. I want to thank him for dying on the cross for my sins. And I want to thank him that he wasn't too busy to hear my cry. I want to thank him for this opportunity of being in his house one more time.
Thank you.
You are praying
for me. Amen.
Praise the Lord, Sister Crystal.
Thank you.
the day, waiting for the day, waiting for the day. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, Sister Wendy.
Everybody ought to get right with God.
Yeah. And do it now. Get right with God. He will show you how. Down at the cross, where he shed his blood. Get right with God. Get right.
Victory in the Holy Ghost. Don't let the devil steal your victory. Just praise him just for keeping me, even though I have to stand alone. I think it was the end of December, and he's considering Muslim and everything. We were just talking about different artists and stuff like that, and I was like, I like a few artists now. It's very few, but I mean nobody's gonna talk about Jesus like that. And he said something. He was like. He's like, I don't really want to get on that. I'm like, oh, no, it's cool. I'm talking about everything. Like, it's cool. And that's when he told me he was considering reading up on the Quran and everything and stuff like that. And he was just talking about different things that the church does and the church doesn't do. I'm like, I agree with some of the, you know, things that they help the community and stuff like that, But even if it's an affront what they do, but they're not serving it through God. You do all these things to help people, but you're not bringing them to the truth.
Right.
And I feel like our churches should do more, and I want to do more, and I wish we can get out and do more for, you know, the community and things like
right.
that, little kids. But it's like I told him, I'm like, even if I have to stand alone, like, that's just what I have to do. Like,
thank
I can
you.
Do what I can until the Lord provides a way. And I just want to thank the Lord, even if I got to stand alone.
All know, right,
I just
now
want to thank the Lord just to keep you.
Amen.
All right. Can't give him a 2-minute break. All right, now we're going to move on to our ushers and musicians. Praise the Lord. Sister Ferguson.
Joy in the Holy Ghost. Don't let the devil steal your joy.
Praise the Lord. Joyful Noise Musical Service, Sunday, February 26, 2012, begins at 4 p.m. at Family Worship Center, 4621 Pelham, Dearborn Heights. There will be great anointed singing and praising. The pastor is Pastor Tommy Lyons and First Lady Sherelle Lyons. The NDC PYPU Retreat 2012.
All right. All right. All right.
Young people, the NDC PYPU Retreat 2012. All right, sounds better. February 24th and 25th at the Lexington Hotel in Lansing, Michigan. I know we've already got our rooms. If you haven't registered, please do so as soon as possible. We will be having, Bishop Noel Jones Friday night. Also, Friday night, the After Hours concert will be James Fortune. Saturday morning for Morning Glory is Elder David Hollis. And Saturday evening is Elder Marvin Sepp. If you have not registered, there is still time. You can actually go to our new website, NDC, not ours, but the ABC, the council website, ABCPYPU.org. You can go there and register. It will also soon be set up so you can register for the councils as well.
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
Amen. ABCPYPU is moving up. All right. We already did the concert. New Hope Tabernacle Youth Department presents Love and Happiness, a special Valentine's Day service today at 4 p.m. with special guest speaker, Evangelist Rebecca Mickens. This will be at New Hope Tabernacle Church, 20221 Lasser Road in Detroit, Michigan, where the pastor is Bishop Suffragan Bishop Rush Lockhart, Jr. Northern District Council Men's Ministry presents its annual men's retreat Saturday, February 18th, 2012, at Gethsemane Apostolic Church of God, where the pastor is District Elder Kevin M. Harrison, who was also a seminar speaker, and the speaker that evening would be District Elder Avery Dumas III. Registration fee men is $25, women is $15. Once again, this is located at Gethsemane Apostolic Church, 17701 Glendale in Detroit, Michigan. Elder James Manns is the NDC Men's Ministry Chairman. Life Center Church of the Apostolic Faith Youth Department, the time is now. This is their youth service, March 2nd, 2012 at 7 p.m. The guest speaker is Sister Christina Barrera. This is at 4488 Britton Road in Grand Rapids, Michigan, where the pastor is Elder Wiley Rigsby II. Agape Apostolic Church will be having their fifth anniversary celebration, The Power of God's Grace. Their speaker for Friday is Suffragan Bishop Eddie Richards and Sunday Bishop Harry L. Herman. Once again, this is Agape Apostolic Church, one of our churches in our district, where the pastor is Pastor R. M. Freeman. Excuse me, Friday, March 9th, and Sunday, March 11th. And I believe Friday they are asking for the district choir to sing. That is district night. So please go out and support one of our churches. Second Mount Zion of the Apostolic Faith is having their 16th annual Missionary Day. Theme, Women That Have Obtained Mercy. They have many things going on. This will be held Sunday, March 18th. At 4:30, dinner will be at 2:30. They are wearing white accented with lavender, not red. The pastor is Elder Eunice Jones. For more information on the things that are happening, this is posted on the back board. District number 10.
Amen. Woo! Amen. Amen. Okay.
District number 10 will convene Friday, March 16th. Pastor's meeting is at 6:30. Worship service, well, pastor's meeting and choir rehearsal is at 6:30. Worship service begins at 7. This will be held at Greater Northside Apostolic Faith Church, 2200 East 7 Mile Road, where the pastor is Elder Craig A. Crook. The speaker will be our district elder.
All right. Yeah. Amen. Amen.
District Elder Ellie B. Cairo, or whom he delegates, from Bethlehem Temple of Belleville. Greater Grace Temple Taylor Singles Ministry presents Motivated to Move Forward, Sunday, March 11th at 3:30 p.m. The speaker is Pastor Nelson A. Henry of Faith Central Church in Detroit, Michigan. They will also be introducing the Greater Grace Temple Taylor Mind Ministry.
Amen.
Again, this is at Greater Grace Temple in Taylor, where the pastor is Bishop Gary Harper.
Amen.
District number 7.
Amen.
We'll convene March 23rd at Faith Temple, where the pastor is Pastor William Alford and our pastor.
Yeah.
Our pastor.
Yeah.
Our pastor, District Elder Clifton D. Hoke, is the speaker. Or who he deems.
All right now.
If he cannot speak.
That's all right.
Once again, this is March 23rd, so don't forget, we have district services back to back. And then the week after is the council.
All right.
I'll see all y'all there.
Amen. Amen.
Hope to see all y'all there.
Amen.
Amen. The Apostolic Church of Jesus weekly announcements are as follows. Monday night prayer. Monday night hour of power.
Amen.
At 7 p.m. Wednesday night Bible class. At 7 p.m. Thursday night choir rehearsal. At 7 p.m. make sure I don't miss anything. Board members, this Friday we have board meeting. All board members, we do have board meeting this Friday at 7.
Amen.
Everybody ought to go to
Sunday school.
The mamas and the papas and the
children too.
Everybody ought to go to
Sunday school.
What time?
9:45 a.m.
A.m., yes. Sunday morning service, which is where you are now, is at 11:30.
Amen.
Amen.
Starting with prayer.
Amen.
Today is second Sunday. It's Missionary Sunday.
Amen.
Please don't forget your $20 for the missionary. This is on top of your tithes and offering.
Amen.
Do not take away from
Amen.
It.
Amen.
Also, today, this morning, is the last day of our winter revival. with Pastor Dr. Mary Ruth
yes.
Montgomery.
Awesome.
The Apostolic Church of Jesus Youth Department will be having their first service of the year. March 18th at 5 p.m.
Amen.
With Evangelist Camilla Holmes of Christ Temple Church in Lansing, where her pastor is Digital Lewis K. Slaughter. Once again, this is March 18th. Tell your friends, tell your family. Even the people you don't like, bring them to hear the word of God.
Right.
That's the important thing. Our desire is to save souls.
That's right.
So young people, bring other young people.
Amen.
Young in age, young in heart, young in spirit.
Come on
now. Even the seasoned saints that still feel young.
Amen.
Bring everybody. We are online. acjesus.org. Follow us on Facebook, like our page. Follow us on Twitter. You can watch us live on Ustream, which is where Sister Harris is right now.
Amen.
Sister Harris. Also, you can subscribe to us on YouTube to watch some of our services.
Amen.
Connect with us.
All right.
These have been your announcements. Please govern yourselves accordingly.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Now we will call up the fantastic,
yes.
The mighty,
yes.
Voices of praise.
Praise.
Praise. Praise. Thank you.
can hear the cries of sinners, but cannot wipe away their tears. You gave me my voice,
oh, yes,
to speak your word, to sing all your praises to those who never heard. But when my eyes are seeing a need for more availability, I see hearts that have many people to be free. Lord, I'm available to you. My will I give to you. I'll do what you say to. Use me, Lord, to show.
Thank you.
sacrifice of angels. Let me hide my sympathy. Hallelujah.
Stream.
All right. Okay, Ustream. I
have to catch up.
Amen. It's all right. It's all right.
I'm still getting out of the 19th century. The 20th century.
That's right.
Coming into the 21st.
Right.
So we got to catch up. But we thank God for the instruments that have blessed us to come this far. God has been gracious unto us.
Yes.
And we do, I'm just reminding you, we do need your help.
Amen.
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 We do need your help.
All right.
We got special, so we need you to do special.
Amen.
I wish I had somebody listening
all
to me.
Right.
But God is good. I just want to put in my testimony. I thank God for blessing me all this time.
Yes, Lord. Yes,
He didn't have to give the strength back.
Yes,
He's blessed me to stand and to be able to expound on God's word. And as God gives me more strength, I want to do more.
Right.
I want to preach. I'm going to stop now. I want you to stand at this time as you receive our speaker, Dr. Mary Montgomery of the Ecclesia Church. Let's receive her with a great big hearty. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. We give honor to the Lord Jesus Christ, who is indeed the head of our lives. We thank God for you, you, and you, and especially you on today. God is a good God. Somebody say, yes, He is. He's good in the morning. He's good in the evening. He's good on a bad day. Fire! Glory to God. Ain't nobody like our God. Isn't that right? We bring you greetings from Ecclesia International Ministry, located 14217 East 9 Mile Road in Warren, Michigan, where I am the pastor of that flock. Hallelujah. And I tell you, God is doing great and marvelous things for us. I give honor to the angel of this house in the person of Pastor Clifton David Hope and the First Lady, Sister Kay Hope and the First Family. We thank God because where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty in the name of the Lord. Well, we had a good time on Friday. We had a good time on Saturday. Now we're back here today giving God some more praise. Somebody say some more praise. God told us Friday night that we was crying over the wrong thing. Get your cry right. Hallelujah. It's time to cry for souls. From the east, the west, the north, and the south. I want to see souls saved. I want to see souls delivered. I want to see God do what He done for me to somebody else. I was a wretched soul undone. I was on the east side of Detroit, Michigan. I was a kid on the other side of the track. I was raised up in an after-hour house. But some kind of way God brought me out. Leaping over walls and jumping over the truth. I thank God that He is the mighty God and the everlasting Father. Somebody shout hallelujah in this house. I praise God because this is a prepared place for prepared people where the Spirit of the Lord is. And if you got time right now, you need to make yourself glory of the Lord that's in that. Yeah.
And wherever the Spirit of the Lord is, you need to find yourself there. Amen. I know some of y'all sitting at home because Whitney Houston died. Hallelujah. But I tell you today, the King of Glory, he's yet alive. Glory to God. He said he ever lived to make intercession for us. He is still alive and he will never die. Hallelujah. Get up. You don't even have to put on no makeup. Just get on up and come on to the house of God. If you would, for just a little while. Turn with us to Deuteronomy, the 11th chapter, beginning at verse 14.
Thank you, Jesus.
And we shall hear what the Spirit of the Lord will say unto us there. Deuteronomy, the 11th chapter. We're going to start here. Let's start at verse 10. For the land whither thou goest in to possess it is not as the land of Egypt from which ye came out, where thou sowest thy seed and waterest it with thy foot as a garden of herbs. But the land whither ye go to possess it is a land of hills and valley, and drinketh water of the rain in heaven, a land which the Lord thy God careth for. The eyes of the Lord thy God are always upon it, from the beginning of the year even unto the end of the year. And it shall come to pass, if ye shall hearken diligently unto my commandments, which I command you this day, to love the Lord your God and to serve him with all your heart and with all your soul, that I will give you the rain. God's going to give you some rain. Rain of your land in his due season. The first rain and the latter rain, that thou mayest gather in thy corn and thy wine and thine oil.
All right.
And I will send grass. God said, I will send grass into thy field for thy cattle, that thou mayest eat and be full. Take heed to yourself that your heart be not deceived.
Come on.
And ye turn aside and serve other gods,
yeah,
and worship them. Concluding with verse 17. And then the Lord's wrath be kindled against you, and he shut up heaven that there be no rain, and that the land yield not her fruit, unless ye perish quickly from off the good land which the Lord giveth you. And the people said,
amen. Amen.
For a little while, I want you to consider for a thought. Get to the land. Get to the land. For a subthought, I'm from the old school, along with Pastor. The subthing will simply be the rain is in the land. First God said, get to the land. Then he said, the rain shall be in the land. Get to the land. The rain shall be in the land. All you want us to do is just get to the land, and the Lord shall be there waiting on us to give us what we have need of.
All right.
It's time for the people of God to walk in divine order.
Uh-huh.
What is divine order? It's simply doing exactly what God has commanded through his word.
Right.
No ifs, ands, and buts about it. All we have to do is just follow his orders. As saints of God, we must realize that we are under authority. Our commander-in-chief is the Lord Jesus Christ. Isn't that right? We were bought with a price and redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Our subject is dealing with rain. Rain is a liquid precipitation that provides initial moisture for plants, animals, and man. In days of old, it let us know in history that rain seldom fell in Judea, except for its season, the former and the latter. The former rain was the end of autumn. It was seed time. Then there was the latter rain. The latter rain was the beginning of spring harvest.
All right.
God dealt with Israel in the natural and the spiritual. Today we shall speak and deal with the church, the called out ones, the ecclesia. We shall deal with them concerning their spiritual state. The book of Deuteronomy is a repeating or a rehearsal of what is to come. Let's just go back just a few chapters. It says in chapter 9, God told the children of Israel that they were getting ready to pass over Jordan.
Come on.
I like this because God had to encourage them. See what Moses did? He sat them down in the beginning of the book and he told them, he said, look at here, this is what getting ready to happen, and this is what have already happened, and God is getting ready to take you into a land that you know not of, a land that you didn't even build, a land that houses that you didn't build, and vineyards that you didn't plant. God began to tell Moses to rehearse that over in their ear. He began to tell them that how God was going to do great and mighty things, that you were getting ready to possess the land.
All right.
God said, the people that's in the land is greater and mightier than yourself. They are of the tribe of Achan. You know the tribe of Achan was giants. Isn't that right? It says there that how Moses told them that there was going to be fenced cities there. And it was going to be a fortress place. It's going to be something that you know in your natural state you can't even get around it. But God is saying to them, don't be afraid. The Lord was going to fight for you. The Lord was going to be your consuming fire. I'm so glad I serve a God that will go before me. I'm so glad I serve a God that will fight for me. The Bible let us know that He is El Elyon. He is the Lord of hosts. He will fight on the behalf of His people. He said, don't worry about the enemies. All I'm asking you to do is just don't be afraid. I came to tell somebody here in Apostolic Church of Jesus, don't be afraid of the enemy. Yes, he looked bigger. Yes, he looked like he can't. You can't beat him. But I hear Mama now saying, the bigger they are, the harder they fall. You got to know your God. You got to know your God is going to take care of you in the day of trouble. He said, don't be concerned about the things that's going to come. The Bible says in Zechariah 4:6, the Spirit of the Lord was upon Zerubbabel. Isn't that right? He said, this thing is not by might nor by power, but it's going to be done by my Spirit. When God declares a thing, it got to come to pass. Church of the Living God, God has spoke to your heart when you first got saved. Even down through the years, God done told you some stuff that He was going to do for you. All you got to do is just wait on the Lord and be of good courage. It don't look like it's going to happen, but if God said it, you can bank on it. If God said it, you can put your foot on it. Higher, glory to God. Don't worry about the enemy. Isaiah 55:11 says, so shall my word be that goes forth out of my mouth, and it shall not return unto me void. But the Bible says, it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the things whereto I have sent it. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says that he could swear by no greater. He swore by himself. Their prosperity was not because they dotted every I nor crossed every T. Aren't you glad about that? Because we as the people of God, we haven't dotted every I nor have we crossed every T. But God's favor is upon us. Isn't that right? God has blessed us. He has called us out. It goes on to say here in Deuteronomy, when they came out of Egypt, how the people of God provoked the Lord. Just let me lay it down and then we'll give you what God has given unto us. The Bible said when they came out of Egypt, they provoked the Lord and they rebelled against Him. His wrath was kindled against the children of Israel because they did not obey God. But how many know that there was a man standing in the gap interceding for the people of God? Just like you all are praying for Bishop here, he's praying for you too. Hallelujah. Even on his sick bed, he's calling your name out. Even on his sick bed, he sees your face before him and he's lifting you up before the Almighty God. But this is what Moses did. Moses had to intercede for the people of God. You remember when Moses went to the mountain, the Bible said that he went up to the mountain that was burning with fire, but it wasn't consumed. The Bible says that Moses stayed on the mountain 40 days. Isn't that right? And 40 nights. And then God began to write on tablets the Ten Commandments. Then after God had got done with the Ten Commandments, the Bible said God told Moses, the leader, somebody said, the leader. God told the leader. God told the leader, he said, get down from the mountain. Those people that you brought out of Egypt, they have corrupted themselves. So the Bible says that Moses went down from the, I'm just rehearsing what Deuteronomy is talking about. The Bible says that when he went down from the mountain, he saw the children of Israel around this golden calf dancing and doing all kind of perverted things. We look at Spielberg or movies and we see just a little touch of what's going on, but these people have become perverted. These people was doing every damnable thing that they could think of in front of each other. Now you know when you do some stuff, you want to do it behind closed doors. But the Bible let us know that when Moses came down, he saw an ugly scene. He saw it and it was so ugly, he began to just throw the tablets down and crush them and begin to fall on his face. That's what a good leader do when he sees the corruption, when he sees things going on that's not right. He begins to intercede. He begins to pray. I hear the songwriter now rolling in my head. Somebody pray for me. Oh, look how you're looking. Had me on their mind. Took the time to pray for me. My pastor prayed. My first lady prayed. My sister prayed. Somebody is always praying for you. You got to realize that the Bible was telling us here how we got to get ready. We got to get ready for what God is doing. So Moses had to intercede for the people of God. Isn't that right? And when he saw this thing, he had to destroy the calf. See, the Lord had already told them early on that when sin comes into the camp, when there's an image that's not like God, you got to destroy it.
Come on.
You got to destroy it. You got to stump it out. You got to turn it into powder. You got to throw it away. See, we as people of God, we can get slick. We can try to put something back together. That's why I'm so glad that the anointing don't break the yoke, but the anointing destroys it. When you want something from God, you better destroy every image that's not like God. Somebody shout hallelujah in this house. Moses began to tell them. He said that God was going to give them the inheritance. God was going to bless them with a mighty stretch out arm. So Moses had to go back to the mountain and he took two tablets back up there. Isn't that right? And then God wrote on the tablets again. How many know God is a God of another chance? I know some of y'all know him as the God of another chance. But whatever chance you own, God is still a good God. Because he's still pricking your heart. He's still dealing with you to come unto him. Now here in Deuteronomy 10, and we get into our text, it says here that God told them again that get up and arise and go and possess the land which I swore unto your fathers. There's some stuff coming down the pipe that God has for us. Yes, I heard the bishop say that he has to move into the 21st century. There's some things that's trying to catch up with you. It came down through the 19th century, the 20th century, and now here it is, the 21st century. God is trying to get some stuff to us, First Lady. God is trying to bless us. God is trying to strengthen us. God is trying to fulfill his promise that he made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And yet, I know you said this is another man's letter. This is another man's note. But I hear God saying that how he grafted us in and made us part of the body of Christ. Isn't that right? So now we are heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus. So whatever God gave to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, guess what? It's mine too. I am a spiritual seed of Abraham. Echo Shema Yoshiah. And everything that I God has for me, guess what? I want it. Then the Lord began to tell them, he said, God was requiring Israel to not to
walk in fear. God was telling them that how all he wanted them to do was to keep his statutes. All he wanted them to do was to love the Lord with all of their heart. He said, just don't be a stiff-necked people. God said, don't be stiff-necked. He said, for I am your God. I am the God of gods, the Lord of lords. He is the great God. Isn't that right? Here in chapter 11, God began to tell them. God said, I want you to listen and obey. He said, I want you to take possession of the land. He said in verse 7, he said, Moses, he said, obey. Moses told them to obey and go in and take it. Church of the Living God, we're being too simple-minded about this thing. If God told us to go and take it, take it. I heard the deacon say, I want to do it. Well, God said, go ahead and do it. God said, if you make yourself a committee of one, somebody will jump on the bandwagon with you. God said that there's much souls that's out here. God said, all I want you to do is just go and do what I told you to do. I hear God saying here in the 7th chapter, how in Egypt they had to irrigate the land. In other words, they had to maneuver the land. But God is saying when we get to the land that he promised us, he's going to take a personal interest in the land. It's like the land of Goshen. Remember? Everything that they had need of was already in the land. Church of the Living God, you're not going to have to work for this. All you have to do is just believe God. And God is going to show up and show out. He said, in this land that God is going to give you, he said, all of your needs shall be supplied. To back that up, we use Philippians 4:19. But God shall supply all of your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. If you need the silver, God's going to give it to you. If you need the gold, God's going to give it to you. He said, the cattle on the hill is mine. Whatever you have need of, God is going to give it to you. I hear Psalms 127. Except the Lord build a house, they that labor in vain. The Bible says all God wanted them to know is that you did not have the ability to get what I'm getting ready to give to you. He said in Deuteronomy 8:18, he said, but thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is the Lord that giveth you power. That power is the ability. That power means the ableness. That power means the might. It is God that's going to give you the ableness to get the power, to get the wealth, that ye may be established, and his covenant which he swore unto his father. In other words, you're getting ready to do great exploits. In other words, you're not going to need the help of a man to do this thing. Some of us waiting on a man to come and affirm us. Some of us is waiting for a man to come and push us into our destiny. But we got to be people of the word. It's on Christ the solid rock we stand. And all of the ground got to be sinking sand. His eye is on the land. God said, if you get to the land, he said, my eyes are already there. All I want you to do is just press your way and get to the land. He said, my eyes are on the land 24/7, 365 days of the year. God said that when he began to think, he thinks freedom. He thinks deliverance. He thinks a time of coming forth. All you need God to do is stop thinking about you. All you need God to do is have you in the forefront of his mind. He said, I know the thoughts that I think concerning you. Thoughts of good and not of evil to bring you to an expected end. I came to tell the church this morning, you have an expected end. You have an expected end. It's time to shake yourself and realize that the drought is over. God is speaking. casting down imaginations and everything that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. I'm talking about a group of people that's getting ready to move into their destiny, move into their place in God. If you cast down everything that's not like God, God said, and continue to walk in His love wholeheartedly, God said, then you can command the rain to come to the land. When you walk in upright before God, you can expect a miracle. You can expect God to do things that eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither have it entered into the hearts of men. All God wants you to do is to cast down everything that's not like Him and continue to love Him. I love Him this morning with my whole heart. Been saved now 39 years and I still love Him. And I'm not going to stop loving Him. For God I live and for God I die. I'll walk with Him. I'll talk with Him. I will listen to Him. Then we can take Church of Living God, when God saved us, He gave us that dominion in this earth. We can call those things that are not as though they are. Church of the Living God, grab hold of the Word of God. He said in Deuteronomy 11:14, He said, I'm going to give you rain of your land in due season. The rain is getting ready to come in the night. What this simply means is God going to give you rain and there shall be no end. In other words, every day shall be howdy, howdy, and never goodbye. Every day you shall have a satisfied portion. Every day God shall give you contentment. I hear now the scripture says godliness with contentment is great gain. Church of Living God, realize today that great gain is coming your way. It is a fact that when Israel received rain, the rain came in abundance. Isn't that right? How many want some rain? How many want God to do what He said that He would do? All God wants you to do is get up and go to your place of destiny. Go to your place where God has designed for you to be at. God said, get up. Start moving. Get up. What no other can do. God told me to tell you that if you come into alignment with the Word, and if you hearken diligently unto the Lord's voice, He said, and observe to do His commandments, He said, these blessings shall overtake thee. These blessings shall be upon thee. And then God Himself was going to set you on high. I don't know about you all, but I need a blessing from God. I need God to show up and show out. God told me to tell you, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit will say unto the church. And what God is saying this morning, He said, get to the land, for the rain is coming. Tell somebody. He said, if my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and forgive their land. God saying, land, I land me rain. Isn't that right? Rain brings life. Rain brings growth. Rain brings nutrition. And even as it is in the natural, so it is in the spiritual realm. The church needs position ourselves. The church need rain so that we can be moist. The church need rain to break up every foul ground that's in our life. There's some foul ground in our life, and if the rain don't come, we will be cracked up. We will be broken. But when the rain comes, it gives us life. It gives us joy. It gives us peace. What's wrong, Zion? We're not in the land that God has called us to be. The land is a position. The land is a place. The land is a destiny. Church of the living God, we are not small in number, but they that are with us are more than they that are against us. There's a mighty army with an apostolic church. There's a mighty army that's fighting your battles. All God wants you to do is position yourself. And when you position yourself, say, God, I'm here. Send the rain. Send the rain. Send the rain. Send the rain. When the rain comes, joy comes, love comes, peace comes, gentleness comes. When the rain comes, we can get rid of everything that's not like God. We can get rid of envy, jealousy, backbiting, lying, and hatred, and jealousy. But we got to get to the land. It's in the land where there's peace. It's in the land where God's joy is. I hear Isaiah saying, I hear an abundance of rain. The rain is coming. The rain is coming. I came to tell somebody it's almost springtime. It's almost time for the latter rain. It's almost time for the spring to come. And when spring comes, rain comes. When spring comes, deliverance comes. When spring comes, winter is over. When spring comes, things begin to pop. Things begin to jump up. Things begin to spring forth. I came to tell somebody, spring is on the way. Spring is on the way. God said when you get there, the springtime will hit. It's not according to the season, but it's according to your obedience. When you get to the place, rain. Somebody say rain. Let the rain fall. Let the rain beat on my head. Let the rain come. Beat on my chest. I want the rain to saturate me. I want the rain to do what it's supposed to do. The Bible says, be a spirit. They stripped him of his clothes, put a crown of thorns on his head, hung him high, stretched him wide. But you and me, he died. Oh, that's not how the story is. 3 days later, he rose again, declaring that all power is in his hand. The Bible says he took his blood, sprinkled it on the mercy seat, so that we can get to a land that's flowing with milk and honey. Without the shedding of blood, there was no redemption of sin. But thank be to God, God gave us the victory through our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Get to the land that purchased by the blood of Jesus. God said, don't be afraid. Tell the devil, I ain't afraid of you no longer. I'm not afraid. Because God has given us the victory. I
got
it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, bless God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. It's time now. God is saying, in this 21st century, to get to the land, the place that I have destined for you to be in. God said it is a place that's flowing with milk and honey.
All right, all right. Word. That's the word. Hallelujah.
Symptom of color.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
When you were testifying earlier, I heard God say that he's calling you into a place.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
He's calling you into a place.
Yes.
Where he wants you to be radical.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus.
There is a reason why the enemy is trying to cut you off.
Yes, it is.
Come on.
Hallelujah. There is more anointing in you than you really realize. God was showing me when you were testifying that you are a hellhound mover. Hallelujah. Oh God, it's not time now to be laid back. It's not time to sit back. You have a job to do. You have a job to walk around this facility. You have a job to walk around this sanctuary and command demons to shout. He tried to put a triple whammy on you. He tried to take you out, woman of God. You got to blank everything out around you and do what God has called you to do. Somebody give God praise. Oh, it's time to war in the spirit. It's time to possess your place. It's time to take your land. Lord, what did you call me to do? You called me to be great. You called me to be a warrior. I got to walk in it.
Help the woman of God.
Hallelujah. This is a new day. This is a day to get bold. I wasn't thinking about who was here, but I was thinking about those that was here in the presence of God. Those that are not here, it wasn't for them. But God said, for you that are here, get to the land.
Hallelujah.
The land is a good place. The land is flowing with milk and honey. This land, the water is coming down through the hills. And now I hear the scripture saying, I will lift up my eyes unto the hill from which cometh my help. My help. My God. Somebody needs to shout hallelujah. My help come from the Lord. I came to tell those that are in this place, it's not what happened on yesterday that counts. It's where we're getting ready to go.
All right.
So what?
All right.
Some of the things you missed on yesterday.
Yes.
You missed the mark on yesterday.
All right.
You didn't dot the I on yesterday. You didn't cross the T on yesterday. Some stuff came into your camp that should not have came into your camp, but it did. But now I got an eye on the devil. I got an eye on him. In other words, God has revealed him. Hoshaya. Echo Shaya. Oh God, I almost went down on that one. God said, I have revealed him. There's an enemy that's been lurking around. There's an enemy. Echo Shaya. They have tried to come into our camp and take our girls out. And there's an enemy that came into our camp to take our men out. Oh, she laid in the gate. She flirted her eyes and she called you into her bed chambers. But I'm so glad trouble don't last always. There is a remedy for those that will call on the name of the Lord. God said before you call, I will. I'm telling you what I know today. Because I've been through. Did I say I've been through?
Yes.
I didn't say I was still there. I said I've been through. See, the enemy got to attack the leaders too. Nobody is exempt from this devil. This is a 21st century devil. This is a devil that's playing games. Look how many people are falling. Some are on drugs and in the church. Some are on drugs. This preaching is great gospel. Some are drinking of a bottle. Some are living in the kind of way. But God said, I got a people that have not bowed to the knee of Baal. I got 7,000 that's getting to the land so that they will worship me. The question is it you? Is it you? The song where I say, I surrender. Hallelujah. I told you Friday night, stop living beneath your privileges. Christ died that we may have the very best. His best joy, his best love, his best peace. Hallelujah. My God. Women of God, men of God, it's time now to move to the next level. Hallelujah. Evangelist Terry, we've been in this way a long time. Now we are becoming the seasoned saints as they so affectionately call us. But we're seasoned because we've been through some stuff. And we're yet standing. And I say to you, my sister, continue to stand. Your place that you have in God, many people wish they can be in. Your peace of mind. Declare control over your area. Control. Take it back. Take it back. The enemy is a liar. He comes with words. Mama used to tell us sticks and stones would break our backs, but names would never hurt us. I found out Mama didn't know what she was talking about. Because words hurt. Words cripple us. Words paralyze us. And that's what the enemy is doing. He's shooting words out at us. But everything that the enemy has said against us,
It won't work.
It won't work.
Somebody shout, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm done. But baby girl, you kept coming before my eyes.
Yes, yes.
It's time to move out in your mind.
Yes, yes.
Stop being locked up. With fear.
Thank you, Jesus.
Don't do it.
All right.
The anointing that's in your hands, oh God, is not the same as Evangelist Terry.
Uh-huh.
Oh God. But God has done something different for you.
Yeah.
When God take you through what he took you through, the anointing is different.
All right.
Can't nobody get mad because God do what he does. Hallelujah.
Yes, that's right.
Woman of God, talk with your pastor. Tell him the things that you have saw in the spirit. Tell him the things that you see in your mind from years back. Share with him. That's what he's here for. He's here to hear the cry of the people of God. God left him here so he can be the day's man, so he can step in and begin to instruct you concerning these media men. Say my God. Spirit of the Lord is here.
All right.
The Spirit of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is in this place. The Spirit of the Lord is here. The Spirit of the Lord is here. The Spirit Jehovah Jireh's here. Jehovah Jireh, set up all over the building, is here. Jehovah, our provider, is in this place. Jehovah Shammah is here. That's the Lord. He's there. He's there. Jehovah Shammah's here. Jehovah, our God, is in this place. Anybody here want to be saved?
Amen.
Anybody came that's outside the ark of safety? You need to come this morning. You need to come. God has so much in store for you. But you need to come and receive from the Master. Are you here? Are you here? Are you here? This is our winter revival. We have heard the word. We have sung unto God. Now, if you would, just give God back your talent. Give God back your gift. Get ready for the springtime. Amen. Father, we thank you right now for your people. We thank you, Lord God, for the place now that they have entered into, Lord. My God, from the preaching of this great dynamic man of God to the preached word today. My God, I know that they've been up under duress.
Yes,
I know they've been up under oppression, depression.
Yes,
yes, but oh my God, we're going to hold on to your word this morning.
Yes, yes,
we're going to hold on, hold on, hold on.
Yes,
I heard God say, help have come your way.
Yes,
I heard God say that he is the lifter of your head.
Yes,
I heard God say that you shall be above and not beneath.
Yes,
I heard God say it's over. The attack of the enemy has issue with is over as of this day. You shall go back home and peace shall be in your home. You shall go back home
Lord. Now, Lord God, we commit them into the hands of a just God. Ebosha. I pray right now, Lord God, that they will begin to move under the auspices of the word of God. For the rain is in the land. The land is the place, the position that you have positioned them in. First Lady has a position, a land. That anointing is in that land. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. We thank you. Oh, we thank you for her position today. We thank you, Lord God, because of trouble. She has moved up a notch in you, Lord God. She has moved into a more of a prayer warrior. She knows how to fight hellhounds, Lord. She knows how to fight demons of sickness, Lord. Hallelujah. And we thank you, Lord God, for her land that she's in.
Yes, Lord.
I thank you for Ashley today, Lord God. The woman of God, the music, the maestro, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, because the music break up the foul ground in order for the seed to be planted. I thank you, Lord God, that she's taking her job serious. I thank you, Lord God, she's taking it so serious that the anointing is there when she opened her mouth. The anointing is there when she began to direct. The anointing is there when she began to MC. The anointing is there when she began to lead her praise service, Lord. We thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for Pastor Lord. Thank you. We need our fathers. Oshatai. Inala mokosha. Eoshaya. Obayasaya. We thank you for our Pastor Lord. One that's standing on this firm foundation. One that's declaring that Jesus is Lord to the glory of God. One that will not give in, nor give out, nor bow to the images that the enemy has set up in these last and evil days. We thank you for the Father, Lord God, that will declare that his holiness or hell, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. We need him around, Lord God, to build up the people of God. To let the people of God know. Now, Father, I ask you to go to their home today. Go to pastor's home. Oh, I need somebody to cry out with me on this one. My God, I need you to walk in every room in that house. My God, there's three of them there. You said a threefold cord is not easily broken. My God, I ask you, Lord God, to bind every hellhound. I ask you, Lord God, to bind every fiend that come up against this ministry. I ask you, Lord God, to give them clarity of thought. I ask you, Lord God, to build this energy back up. Build it, build it. Build it up like you did, Caleb. Caleb said, I'm as strong today as I was yesterday. My God, build them up. Do it for your name's sake. My God, I ask you to do it because he loves you. Now, Lord God, bless this congregation. Every member, Lord God. Whatever their hands find to do, let them do it to the glory of God. My God, I pray that you will put a word of deliverance in their mouth to bring souls in. Souls, souls, tell somebody. It is your job. It is your job to tell somebody to come into the table. It is your job to tell somebody to come to the feast. It is your job to tell your mom and them, your daddy, your brothers, your sisters. You got to tell somebody. My God, I pray right now that you would help them to go and tell somebody in the blessed name of the Lord. Now, Lord God, we thank you for the preach word. My God, you have done what no other could do. And we will give your name praise because we know that the rain is in the land.
Hallelujah. Come on, somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. One more time, shout hallelujah. Lift your hands and shout hallelujah. God has sent his word. God has sent his word. I thank God that I have not spoken to Dr. Montgomery about Apostolic Church of Jesus, not one way or the other. I had no conversation whatsoever. But the word she spoke was the Apostolic Church. I didn't even know she was here this morning. I didn't see her till I came out to go into the pulpit. God is great. He spoke to us. He spoke to our hearts and our minds. He spoke to our situation that we would believe Him, trust Him, and wait on Him. He's still God. He's still God. All by Himself. No matter what anybody else says, He's still God. We thank God. We're not going to prolong the time. She made an altar call. There was none that come, but you understand that we stand ready at all times to receive souls. God is blessing me. I'll be able to get out of bed, not as quick as I used to.
That's all right.
Yes.
But I'll be able to get out of bed, get my clothes on, come down. Right. I'll baptize people 1, 2 o'clock in the morning.
All right,
it was no matter to me. And then stay down on the altar for 2 or 3 hours.
Thank you. Thank you.
Waiting on the Lord to fill their souls. I know we don't do that today.
Yes, sir. Come on now.
Have mercy, Lord.
We stay all night. But everybody's got to go to work now.
Yes.
They're tired.
Yes.
But God is still good.
Yes. All the time.
He's still merciful. I love Him because He has first loved me.
Yes,
now we're going to receive offering. Those that are on live stream, you can send your offerings and donations on our website, acjesus.org, or our online giving page.
All right.
And we'd just like to thank you in advance for your giving.
That's right.
Thank God for Sister Ashley in providing these things. It takes me a little time to learn them.
It's all right.
It's all right. It's all right.
And get used to them. But God is still God.
Yeah.
We want you to prepare for offering.